Okay, so I'm going to take another shot at making a turkey tail here. This is a spall. I just took this off this nodule. Or did I? Oh, there it is. So, what I did here kind of messed me up a little bit. I lost some of my width. I was going to position a point right here. And what I was trying to do was, was hit, right there is where I struck, and I was trying to get a piece to come off the bottom here. But what happened was, it wrapped. The flake wrapped. It kind of took some of my material, but this is a nice, really nice spall here. Probably be better off just to start out with this one. But this will be our backup here, so I'll start with this one and see what we can do. It might not be a real wide turkey tail, but we'll do a turkey tail one way or another. Turkey tail. Some nice thick cortex on here, but it does flake, surprisingly. You can't really hit right on the outside of it, but you come in on a little bit, you can get flakes to run. Okay, so here and here, I want to leave some cortex on my tip and base. So I've got some thickness to work with. As far as here, so I need to remove this mass first, maybe, because it's sticking out the farthest. Let's see what's the best way to go about this is. The way this edge is overhanging, I'm just, you know, I'm going to take that back because it's not any good to me. There's no mass in front of it. Can't really run a flake. Just take some short flakes to level that surface out a little bit. It would have hurt if I dropped that on my toe. Jack Crafty would be laughing at me. He's always making fun of people that flint knapping or flip flops. I have to agree, there's probably better, much better footwear. But it's hot outside. My feet get hot. I like to let my pigs breathe and get them out in the air. I'm just setting a platform here to come back across this direction. Probably pretty good. Take too much. That was a swing and a miss right there. Be cool to make a big blade core out of this stuff. That one there might come in handy. I put it up there with the other 685 of them I got. That was a little better. You know you're getting good when you can take two flakes at once. This is pretty hard stuff. I could hit right on the outside of that. Let me just get rid of some of this Cortex. It'll help me out in the end. I don't want any of that powdery stuff left on the point anyways. There we go. That helped. On it. Why is that doing that? I think I've just got too much back edge support, maybe. That flake rolled right through there. Oh, man. I mean, I'll still make a beautiful point, but it's getting too small now. All right, I'm gonna switch over to my backup piece. Probably the one I should have started with. So my length is probably gonna be in here. It's like good material comes almost all the way through. If I remove this ridge, I end up having my both ends end up somewhere right in here. So I'll be able to use some of this, hopefully some of this Cortex. I might not get Cortex on the bottom, but on this end I might probably be able to preserve it up here. Just not a lot of it down here to begin with. this stuff's really bad about clogging your copper up. It's real chalky cortex, like kind of like Georgetown's got and stuff. Sometimes you can kind of flub a flake when you get too much of that stuff built up in there. It keeps the edge from wanting to grab. Man, I got some pretty substantial dings in there. Just an old farrier's rasp I got. It's just got this single cut file on the one side and a rasp on the other. I've got another new one I use for my bone tools and antler and stuff, but I use this one on my copper. Try to get one here first. That'll kind of help isolate this mass right here. What are you doing? Better look out. Been out there in the rain. Weirdest cat. Most cats hate anything to do with water. You'll get out there, right out there in it, won't you? There we go. Get rid of that old cortex. I can do this without wrapping the other side off. That's what I was trying to do right here, but it didn't work out. Build me a little platform right here on the side of this and come at it from that direction. I think I can get rid of that nasty stuff. Nope. Just added to it. Some of it. that surface, I should have pointed that out, it was like a convex surface. It was rounded. And when the surface is rounded, the flake scoops in. It's almost like if you flipped a shovel over upside down and took a scoop out like this. So it's more of a, it goes, the flake starts out going deeper into the edge, and sometimes that can cause problems, like because it'll bite off more than it can chew. But there's other times you can use that to your advantage when you're, especially when you're spalling and you're you know, certain situations like this. I wanted to get underneath that step fracture, and because the surface was rounded, it was like a crown platform. Usually that's not good, you don't want that. But in order to get under that step fracture, I knew that the crack would initiate and dive in straight in like this. So sometimes if you get a rounded surface on your platform, you know, rounded as in humped up, convex, that can help you get rid of these step fractures. If not, you can always just raise your edge up higher and get closer to the problem and beef it up. And a lot of times you can get under them like that too. So, a little quick tip. So I still got a little waviness going on here. I need to take some off here and maybe a little bit back here. I'm gonna try to take most of it from right here. I'll just bring this edge up. One little piece of my aggressive course abrader here. Okay, that little one will put me on the right track here, hopefully. Okay, that's helping. If I can get one from over here, I'll be in business. Whoa. I'm hoping I can catch a little bit of this color phasing in and out on the back side of this here, so I can get maybe get a cool pattern. Okay, so I took some time preparing that edge so I could sneak that flake off there. Now I've got a point where I can get some contours I can work with. Man, this is got myself in a little bit of a bind here. It's gonna be a tricky one. Always work into the problems. Yeah, sneak up on them from the side sometimes. Step, but I'm not worried about it because I'm still doing a lot of thinning. Lots of thinning. Get rid of some of this cortex. This tip will end up being really constricted. I'm coming in kind of skinny. If I'm able to make the one I want to make anyway. Look at you. Look at her. You're covered up in Flint. Crazy cat. You're crazy. Straight loony. Oh, man. All right. There. All right, so now is when I need to kind of slow down and start really getting picky. I knew that wasn't gonna happen. Because it had that bump on it. You see, you guys see that bump on that platform? I knocked most of it off there, but it had a ridge on top there. That's why she didn't let go. That's why it's still not letting go. This is kind of in my way to hit this platform, so I'm just gonna move it. You know, it really helps me to visualize. If I pause before I take the flake and visualize the flake coming off there, seems to help a lot of the time. Not sure why, but could have hit that, but I'd probably hit that ridge right there, and it would have caused the platform, excuse me, to fail, most likely. Boy. Symmetry is getting a little crazy here. I think I was chipping and not paying attention to where I was chipping, and I kind of got a little cockeyed. So if this is going to be our point still, constrict this in. Starting to look like something now. What are you doing? Go on. I still got a little bit of the lighter color up here at the tip, so that's pretty cool. Kind of looked out there. Probably need to switch over to pressure. I really need to get a flake right in here. See if I can come in from here maybe. Help to get one right there first. Nice. Ouch. Ouch. That one hurt. Come on, baby. All right. So, do a little pressure flaking, not much. Whoops. That was a whoopsie daisy there. That's what I get for not downsizing my tools. My best to get rid of this thick spot. I'm going to do that by using my indirect percussion tool. I'm going to come right across here, see if I can clear some of this out. Take one last look at the flake I want to take. I'm pushing in right behind, right straight across from where my tool is with my fingertip to apply that back edge pressure. I got surface support. I'll try to get this to clean all that junk off there. Pushing in. You've got some of it. Took care of all of that mass. and get one right here. I got a little cleanup to do over here. I got to fix this edge up, and then I'll have to try to match this side up to that side, I guess. Or split the difference. That's what I usually do. Flint flake between my toes. I'm getting there, slowly but surely. I had my symmetry way out of whack. Coming in there now, though. Take a little bit more off. And takes a little bit more right here, it looks like. I keep pulling from this spot. It just doesn't seem to be making a huge difference. You guys haven't played around with buffalo horn yet, I would recommend it because it's a really neat tool. Come in really handy for shearing and all kind of good stuff. It takes some getting used to, and I'm still getting used to it, but you get some really neat results with it. Still working on getting the feel for the edge, what that edge feels like when it's ready to have a flake taken. Come on, darling, you're getting there. Getting real close. Get this thing figured out here. Got a little bit thick on me from bringing the edges in so much, but it's still not too bad. I think I'm just gonna go ahead and notch it, and let me work on the symmetry a little bit more. I'm going to be careful about taking flakes with copper right now because all the rest of it is done in buffalo. So it might look weird. I'm going to throw some notches in this bad boy and that'll be it. I want to mark it up. I guess that'd be the A side there, probably. And the B side. This side looks really good. It's not paper thin, but it's okay. It'll be all right. I can just get a couple little notchy notches in here. These are probably the easiest points to notch in the world. I mean, I thought for sure that would go. That's really all I need. I just wanted to. Maybe not. Alright, that's fine. I can live with that. least flake in there. All right. Hey, that's a sweet one. How long was that? It's got to be over an hour. Hour and 11 minutes. That was a long one. But that is a sweet little turkey tail, I do believe. Out of a really cool piece of rock. Really need another flake out of this notch, but I don't want to mess it up. I think it's passable now, so I'm going to probably just leave it like that. All right, Tim, there you go, buddy. This one's coming to you. I appreciate your interest in my work and your business. Thanks for watching, everybody. Let me know if you want one of these dang things made, and I'll try to bang one out for you. All right, guys, I'll catch you on the next one.